the next competition shot, load. The 2012 shooting sports season continues. We are in the middle of the Olympic year, just weeks away from the opening ceremony of the London Olympic Games. And it's time to get ready for the most important match of the year. We're in Milan, a city of fashion, business, and sport. And we are here for the second stage of the ISSF Rifle and Pistol World Cup Series, the home of shooting in town. They're all here, the best shooters of the world, over 500 athletes coming from 72 countries, gathered at the Tiro Assegno Nazionale shooting range in Milan, a traditional location for high performance. They're all tuned up, ready to go, peaking at their best on the way to the games. Competing here in the 10 Olympic events of rifle and pistol shooting. The focus of the champions is on the targets. Our focus is on the champions, who will rise up to the cup. Good afternoon, friends, and welcome to day one here at the Tiro Assegno Nazionale in Milan, Italy, where we're kicking off with 10-meter air rifle men. Italy's own 2010 world champion, Niccolo Campriani, enters tied for first with 599 points. We've got a tight competition on our hands with only 3 points separating first through eighth. Shot 8 for the 2010 Junior World Championship silver medalist. A 10.6 will get him closer to the bronze. Belarus's Bubnovich, a solid 10.6. Chu, can he hold on a second with Bubnovich at his heels? A 10.4. And with that 10.4 from Chu, has moved him down into third, being overtaken by Bubnovich, and Kulish is 1/10 of a point behind. Shot 9 for Kulish. A 10.5. A 10.5 also for Bubnovich. Chu needs a 10.4 to tie Kulish, and he's done it. Campriani with a 10.5 has 1.8 tenths of a point lead. It's going to be the last shot to find out who's going to be on the podium with only 2 tenths of a point separating second from third, and Chu and Kulish tied up. Last shot for 19-year-old Kulish. A 10.6. Campriani a 9.8, and it's enough for the gold. A 10.4 for the 2004 Olympic Games gold medalist, and he's lost his chance for the podium. A 10.6 for Bubnovich seals the deal for the silver by 2 tenths of a point. Gold medalist Niccolo Campriani has made his country proud. Campriani, Bubnovich, and Kulish, medal winners for 10-meter air rifle men.
Sì, era... una medaglia di 3P a Londra, una medaglia d'aria qui, due gare completamente diverse.
It was a three positions gold medal in London. It's an air rifle gold medal here. Two completely different finals, one in freezing cold in London, and here it was much different.
A casa in Italia, insomma, il tifo può aiutare.
There was big pressure here at home. Normally supporters help in many sports, but shooting isn't one of them.
Un po' di aspettative, però ho saputo gestire anche queste pressioni.
I've been able to manage this pressure. Shooting in difficult conditions and winning makes it a very good souvenir to carry with me to the Olympic Games.
Un bel ricordo per da tenere per i giochi.
Welcome back to the Tiro Assegno Nazionale shooting range for the second final of the day, 10-meter air rifle woman. The Czech Republic's 2008 Olympic Games gold medalist enters tied for first after equaling the world record. As you can see, it's going to be another tight fight for the podium as we only have 3 points separating first through eighth. And with such talent, anything could happen. Teammates and spectators have come here to cheer on these fine athletes. Shot 8 for Shearer. A 10.3. Emmons. A 10.2, and she's clearly disappointed with this. File Shifter needs a 10.8 to tie up with Emmons. A 10.5. Emmons holding on to first by a mere 3 tenths of a point. Du has overtaken Shearer and is 4 tenths of a point behind Yi. The 2010 world champion. A solid 10.7. Her teammate, 2004 Olympic Games gold medalist, a 10.6. Emma needs to shoot deep. A 10.6. On to the two-time world champion, a 10.0. Emmons is holding on to first by 9/10 of a point and due a half a point away from the bronze. Last shot for Yi. A 10.9. What a way to finish us off. This will give her the bronze. Emmons, a 10.7 in the gold. File shifter shooting for the silver. A 10.3 puts her on the podium. Gold medalist Katarina Emmons is back. Emmons, file shifter, and Yi will be on the podium today.
Tired. I need lots of ice cream. My brain is really tired because I have to work really hard for it. It wasn't easy, although everybody told me it looked really easy, so I'm glad at least it's looking easy from the outside, but it was really tiring and hard.
Welcome to day two here in Milan, Italy at the Tiro Assegno Nazionale shooting range for 10-meter air pistol woman. Elena Kostovich, currently ranked number one in the world, enters in first with 392 points. Kostovich, with a three-point lead, and these talented shooters will have a good fight on their hands. Tien, who just won the gold in London, and Shaika, a two-time World Cup final silver medalist, fighting it out for the bronze. Tien, not happy with a 9.2. Shaika needs a 10.4 to tie with Tien, but shoots a 9.9. Kostovich and Maruskova still holding on to the top positions, and Tien now with a half a point lead over Shaika. Kostovich, with a 9.8 on her last shot, wins the gold. The second medal in this discipline during the 2012 ISSF World Cup season. Maruskova, who just won the bronze in London, finishes with a 10.3 in the silver. Gold medalist Elena Kostovich. Kostovich, Maruskova, and Tien, medal winners once again for 10-meter air pistol women. Welcome back again today here at the Tiro Assegno Nazionale shooting range, this time for 10-meter air pistol men. Han Zhongliang enters in second place with 585 points. With only 3 points separating the top four men, will prove to be an interesting final. Turkis Gilis, a 10.6 and putting the pressure on Bakhtamyan. Bakhtamyan, looking disappointed, has now moved down to fourth place. The 2006 World Championships bronze medalist is still holding on to second. The pressure's on with Goncharov 7/10 of a point behind Tan, and Bakhtamyan 4/10 of a point behind Kiels. Shot 9 for Kiels. A deep 10.7. Tan, a 9.1. Goncharov can overtake Tan with a 9.9 or higher. A 10.1 jumps the 2006 World Cup final gold medalist up to first. And here you have it. Goncharov's in first by 3/10 of a point, and Kiels, who's never entered into a final round of a World Cup, in third by 6/10 of a point. Last shot for Kiels, 10.5. Tan, a 10.0. Goncharov needs a 9.8 for the gold. Oh, a 9.1 knocks him down for the bronze. Gold medalist, Tan Zhongliang. Tan, Kiels, and Goncharov will be on the podium today.
Uh,
Today I felt that every competitor could win the gold medal. I just had more luck. Good afternoon and welcome to day three here at the Tiro Senio Nazionale shooting range for today's final 50 meter rifle three positions men. USA's one-time World Cup gold medalist enters in first place with 1,173 points. Campriani in second, and Breen and Miroslaviev tied for third.
The chief range officer is Roberto Cagnà.
Stop. Unload.
Sokolov, 10.7.
2010 Junior World Championship silver medalist, a 9.3. Miroslaviev, another 9.1. Parker now four solid points above Campriani, and Chaika putting the pressure on Miroslaviev.
Miroslaviev, 9 points.
Parker putting up a good fight. A 9.1. Campriani, a 10.1.
Stop.
Parker still in the lead, followed by Campriani. 1.3 tenths of a point difference between third and fourth.
Breen, 10.3.
Last shot for the 2010 World Cup final bronze medalist. Oh, an 8.6 loses his chance for the podium. Parker finishing with a 9.8 in the gold medal.
Stop.
Campriani a 10.4 in his second medal this week.
There are no time.
Gold medalist Jason Parker from the United States of America.
The gold medal winner is, thank you.
Parker, Campriani, and Sharika, medalists for 50-meter rifle, three positions men.
I feel extremely excited. You know, I came here, this is where I shot my very first international competition here on this very range, and this could be my last World Cup. So, you know, finish it like this, I'm very happy.
Welcome to day four here at the Tiro Segno Nazionale shooting range in Milan, Italy, for the first final of the day, 50-meter rifle, three positions woman. 1998 world champion Sonia Fileshifter enters in first place with a total of 588 points. Fileshifter, with a three-point lead over Emmons and Shushko, who has never entered into a final round of a World Cup, 2 points behind. Shot eight for 19-year-old Ungerang, who's currently in third place. And she shoots a 9.1. Lee coming off an 8.4 with a 9.8. File shifter, always the last one to shoot. And a 9.9, and she's not happy with this score. Emmons, a 10.3.
Emmons, 10.9.8.
File shifter and Emmons in the lead, and only 3 tenths of a point separating third from fifth place.
2.8.7. Gray, 10.
Shot 9 for Ungerank. A 9.3, and she's clearly frustrated with that. Lee with a 9.7 overtakes Ungerank by 2 tenths of a point. Emmons holding on strong with a silver, a 10.4, and she's satisfied. File shifter, a 10.2, and going strong.
File shifter, 10.4.
File shifter in the lead by 5.1 tenths of a point. Emmons in second, and Lee is now in third over Ungerank by 2 tenths of a point.
Lee.
Last shot for Ungerank, a 9.5. Lee, a 10.2, will seal the deal for the bronze. Emmons, finishing with a 9.9 in the silver, and her second medal of the week. File shifter, her last shot, but the gold is already hers. Finishes with a 10.6. And here she is, gold medalist, Sonia Fileshifter. Fileshifter, Emmons and Lee, medalists for 50-meter rifle, three positions woman.
Thank you.
Welcome once again today here at the Tiro Segno Nazionale shooting range in Milan, Italy for 25-meter pistol woman. Elena Kostovic enters in first place with a total of 589 points. Kostovic with 3 points over Gobervi and Salukvadze tied up with Shaika.
Take your position. 2 minutes.
First series for Bonova and Maruskova. Both with a 10.5 on their first shot. Serbia's 1988 Olympic Games bronze medalist. Starting off strong. In fact, after shooting a total of 51.6 on her first series, Shekarich has moved up from 6th place to 3rd. Kostovic and Gobervi on top. Series 2 for Kostovic, who's really in her prime this season. The 2004 Olympic Games silver medalist, who has already moved up from 7th to 4th. The standings have changed. Maruskova has overtaken Shekarić and is 1.6 tenths of a point behind Gobervi. Shekarić. Maruskova. Kostovic is once again performing outstandingly and is going for a second gold of the week. The standings have once again changed. Maruskova has overtaken Gobervi, and with only fractions of a point separating 3rd through 6th place, and Kostovic is in 1st by 6.1 tenths of a point. Last series for last year's World Cup final gold medalist. Kostovic, with precision and shooting like a star, has bagged the gold. Gold medalist Elena Kostovic winning her second gold of the week. Kostovic, Maruskova, and Shekarić, who grabbed the bronze in the last series, are today's medalists. It's the first time that I won two gold medals during the same World Cup, and I'm very, very happy.
Brilliant.
Welcome to Day 5 here at the Tiro Segno Nazionale shooting range in Milan, Italy, for today's final 25-meter rapid-fire pistol men. The Russian Federation's Alexey Klimov, who just won the World Cup gold in London, enters in first place. The results after qualifications? Keep in mind, now the scores will be canceled and all the shooters will start with 0 points. Moving on to the shoot-off for the bronze, Klimov, Reitz, and Schumann, all with 29 hits. Klimov. 4 out of 5 hits. Reitz. 2 out of 5 hits. All Schumann, a 3-time Olympic Games gold medalist, has to do is nail 3 out of 5 and he'll be going for the gold. He's only hit one. Schumann has put up his hand and we'll see if this is a malfunction. He's getting his backup pistol ready. But to his surprise, it's not a malfunction, as the pistol has been shot without problems. Ralph Schumann, bronze medalist. On to the fight for the gold. Klimov, a perfect 5 out of 5, and the spectators love it. The pressure's on Wright. He has to have a perfect string to stay in the game. And the crowd goes wild with Wright's performance. Ladies and gentlemen, we're in for a shoot-off for the gold between Klimov and Wright. Klimov shooting first. 3 out of 5. It's on to Wright. He needs 3 to tie and 4 for the gold. And 2 isn't going to do it. Klimov and Wright both setting a new final world record with 34 hits. Here he is once again, winning the gold, Alexey Klimov. Welcome to the last day here at the Tiro Segno Nazionale shooting range here in Milan, Italy, for the first event, 50-meter pistol men. Serbia's Damir Mikec enters in first with 574 points, an impressive 6-point lead over the others. Following Mikec, we have Zhang and Wang. Giordano. An 8.8, and once again the Italian spectators are sucking in their breaths. Bakdemian, an 8.9, keeps the 2 in close fight for the bronze. Zhang, a 9.9. Mikec, a 10.2, and the crowd likes it. One more shot to go, and we still have Bakdemian and Giordano fighting out for the bronze. Last shot for Giordano, an 8.9, and he's upset to say the least. Our lead man, Mikec, finishes with a 9.3 in the gold. Unbelievably, Bakdemian and Giordano are in a tie and will be going into a shoot-off. Zhang finishing with a 9.5 in the silver. Gold medalist Damir Mikec is back. With the rowdy crowd cheering on the shooters, it will be down to the one shot for the bronze. Giordano, zeroing in, a 10.2. The pressure's on Bakdemian. And he disappointedly hits a 7.6. Bronze medalist Giordano climbed up from 8th and stole the bronze. Mikec, Zhang, and Giordano, medalists for 50-meter pistol men. It's the last final here at the Tiro Segno Nazionale shooting range here in Milan, Italy, and we're finishing with 50-meter rifle prone men. Two-time Olympic Games bronze medalist Sergei Martynov enters tied for third with a total of 597 points. Only 3 points separating first through eighth will prove to be a tough final.
The chief range officer for this final is Roberto, also have a tie for the third position.
Shot 8 for Di Nicolo. Another 10.2. A 10.6 for McPhail. Graf, a 10.0, and this is going to change the standings. A 10.4 for Martynov, who's still in first place. The standings say it all. Martynov in first by 3/10 of a point. McPhail has overtaken Graf and is holding on by 3/10 of a point. Shot 9 for Di Nicolo. A 9.8. McPhail, distressed with a 9.3. Graf, a solid 10.6, and he's going to jump up the notch on the scoreboard. Martynov, a 10.5, keeps the 6-time World Cup final gold medalist ahead. Graf has overtaken McPhail, and we have a 2-way tie for third between McPhail and Di Nicolo, with one last shot to go. Martynov finishing up with a 10.1, his lowest score of the final. Graf, a 10.4, won't be enough to overtake Martynov. Di Nicolo, a 10.3, earns him the bronze. Martynov winning his second World Cup gold medal of the 2012 season. Martynov, Graf, and Di Nicolo will be on the podium. So that's a wrap from Milan, Italy. Next stop, Munich, Germany, as we make our way down the road to the London Olympic Games. See you soon, shooting fans.